My name is Jared Hoffman, and I'm a graduate student. I grew up in Missouri. It was in the St. Louis area, about 45 minutes away from St. Louis. My dad was a salesman, and then my mom, she works at a college, East Central College in Missouri, and she works with accounting. So none of them are in the science field. In high school, I did health occupations, where I went around a lot of different hospitals and saw a lot of different occupations, shadowed doctors, pharmacists, well, pretty much you name it. So I guess that's kind of what got me interested in it. And then also in high school, I got really interested in nutrition, trying different diets and things like that. So then in my undergrad, I was interested, well, in science, so I went with biology. I did my undergrad at Truman State University, which is in Kirksville, Missouri. And then for my master's, I went to the University of North Carolina at Greensboro, and I did my master's in nutrition there. I knew I wanted to do research. I liked nutritional science. I liked pharmacology. In Kentucky, I interviewed with Dr. Lin, and her research was really fascinating. It was right up my alley. And also with UK, it seemed like, and I'd heard it was a very collaborative network with different professors and students. And also during the application process, some of the professors were very helpful to me. They went above and beyond to try and get me here, which I was very impressed with. You know, they actually seemed like they really wanted me here. So yeah, I mean, UK seemed like a perfect fit about every way, and I felt right at home. So I'll be studying pharmacological and nutritional sciences, and I'll be looking at rapamycin and ketogenic diets, and we'll look at that with Alzheimer's and aging and maybe other markers in the brain. So a ketogenic diet's a high-fat, low-carbohydrate diet. It'll be primarily fat, probably about 60 to 70% fat. You'll end up having the body create more ketones, like beta-hydroxybutyrate, and the brain can then run on beta-hydroxybutyrate or as opposed to glucose, along with other tissue like muscle. I was always interested in ketogenic diets, which is ketosis, which, you know, is elicited with starvation process, and now thinking it might have other benefits with Alzheimer's disease, and maybe we don't have to spend as much on, you know, pharmaceuticals. So ketogenic diet would help that, might be a little bit cheaper. And so with this research, I'm really excited about seeing how that can help Alzheimer's disease, and I guess in the end, helping people out in the prevention and treatment of the disease, and maybe other neurological diseases as well. So there are periods when a lot of your experiments get you results you think, or I guess you almost want to happen, that that support the hypothesis. And then other times you'll go through kind of dry spells where a lot of the results don't end up as you think they might. So that might make you lose a little bit of confidence. But I guess it's really the challenging part is not giving up and, you know, to try to keep moving forward to, you know, keep learning. All of us either know somebody or have a family member that has had, you know, neurological diseases. Like I have a grandma that had Parkinson's, or we know someone that has cancer or some other disease that really affects us. So I think with science we can try to improve the amount of knowledge we have about those, which will then help improve our treatment and prevention of these diseases. And I think in the end that'll help us really improve our health care and our health, help us live happier and healthier lives. Thank you.